Alright guys, and welcome to another FIFA Ultimate Team player review. Now if you watched my Man of Match Higuain video yesterday, you would have said, or this morning, you would have heard me say that I said I would do Inform Santi Cazorla. However, I've just randomly lost all the clips that I've done on him, so unfortunately I cannot do Inform Santi Cazorla, but I do have a backup plan, and it is Cautomotic Blanco, the Mexican legend, the oldest player in FIFA Ultimate Team. I am reviewing his Inform, and as you can see there, the guy is a hero. 41 years old, his base stats are 28 pace, 72 dribbling, 72 shot, 33 defending, 81 passing, 58 physical, and as you saw there, he has low work rates, 4-star skill moves, and a very good 5-star weak foot. Now, some of his in-game stats I can't show him because FIFA doesn't show the Inform stats properly, it only shows the normal card, but some of his in-game stats are awesome. He's got 88 curve, 88 free kicks, 81 long passing, 99 penalties, which is awesome, and 99 stat. He's also got 83 long shots. Now, obviously, this guy's the oldest playing FIFA Ultimate Team, and he's double my age. What an amazing guy to get an Inform, you know. He got his Inform by scoring a free kick and a penalty to get his team back into the game in a Mexican League match. So, obviously, he deserved it, and at 41 years old, that is absolutely amazing. So, I'll start off with his positives then, you know, his dribbling. Now, obviously, he's got really good dribbling stats. 81 for a silver card is absolutely amazing. Obviously, his pace, he can't get away from anyone, if you know what I mean, and his agility. You know, his agility is 35, so he can't weave in and out of defenders. However, this guy's dribbling is awesome. The ball sticks to his feet. You can tell he's a quality player. I mean, if you watch some of his, well, some videos on him, or if you've ever seen him play before, when he was younger, he was amazing at dribbling. He was a fantastic player, and I suppose he's still doing it pretty well if he can get an Inform card. But there you go, his dribbling is really good. The ball does stick to his feet, and it was quite fun to use, to be honest, considering he has absolutely zero pace. So we'll go on to his shot. Again, he has very good long shots. However, I'll go on to his shot power, let him down a bit. But the guy can finish. You know, you've just probably seen from a few clips here, his finesse shot's absolutely awesome. He's got awesome curves. So if you can get the ball outside the box with him, obviously I played him centre attacking mid, so he gets a few chances, and he doesn't move with his low work rates. Finesse shot with him, guys, honestly. Finesse shot, it'll get on target. It is awesome. You know, he can curve it round the keeper. He can do all sorts of things. And that helps with his passing as well as his curve. And we'll go on to his passing. You know, it's absolutely amazing for a card that's, well, as old as him. He can pick people out with such ease. Apple obviously played him a full silver squad, and I would recommend playing him in with silver tournaments, you know, to get that feel of him, because obviously I did come up against quite a few gold teams as well. Well, more so gold teams, actually. I do play online single matches, and at times, obviously, stamina goes down and he gets caught out by better players. However, his passing is amazing. He can pick any through ball out to your striker, over the top or on the floor. It's absolutely awesome. Free kicks, as you've probably seen as well, some of his free kicks are unreal. He's probably one of the best free kick takers I have ever had on this game. I love his free kicks. He could bend them round the wall. Power shots, despite his power being poor, his free kicks were really good. Now, obviously, his cons are very simple, and you'll see that in a second. His pace is shocking. He can't get away from anyone. He's very slow, and as you can imagine, his stamina is shocking. It's 26. He just can't get away from anyone. You can see here his pros and cons. I'll keep on going about his cons. He's forever injured, literally. He has never, ever, ever finished a game without getting injured. I played about 12 games with him, and he was injured every single time. Obviously, his stamina goes down very fast as well. He loses 9 stamina every game, without a doubt, unless they quit out. And his agility is shocking as well. But, you know, he is a 41-year-old legend, this guy. And if you put him in a team as a centre-attacking mid, or even a centre-forward, I recommend him as a centre-forward as well. He can pick the passes out for you, and he can shoot. And that is exactly what you want. His dribbling isn't bad. And within the first half, before he fucking dies on the pitch of an heart attack or whatever else, he really is a fantastic player to use. And I'm glad I played with him. He cost me around 60,000 coins. If you've got the coins and you want a challenge with a legend, I really recommend trying this guy out. He's really fun to use, to be honest, guys. But that is it. I'm sorry about the Santi Cazorla view. I will try and get him back to do a few more clips on him. But that is it. So thank you for watching. If you've liked this video, please like, comment and subscribe. Let me know what you think. Give this guy a try if you can. So thank you for watching. Have a good Christmas and have a very good day.